using mediated learning experience in dynamic assessment. Again, my financial disclosures are that I'm a professor and associate dean at the University of California at Irvine. I receive financial compensation from ASHA. So here we're going to talk about what is mediated learning experience. What are the essential components of mediated learning experience? How do you build a lesson based on MLE? So dynamic assessment consists of a test, teach, and retest approach. Testing is usually based on some aspect of your assessment results. And in dynamic assessment, you're going to probe that area a little bit more to have a deeper understanding of what the child knows and doesn't know. And so, for example, we gave TNL example earlier. So a child might tell a story on a standardized test. And maybe in the dynamic assessment probe, you pull out the frog stories and you get a longer narrative sample, or you get another narrative sample. Mediated learning is the teaching portion of the dynamic assessment. And here we're going to develop a lesson around principles of mediated learning that are going to support story telling for the particular child that that you're working with, or that's going to support whatever area of need that child might have. So these are some components of a mediated learning experience. So the first is intentionality, and intentionality is really critical in dynamic assessment. It involves a statement of the teaching goal that you share with a child. So you explain to them why you're doing what you're doing. You're not necessarily here to play. You're here to learn how to tell better stories. So explaining the goal to the child helps them understand the purpose of that teaching session. And later we're going to see how we probe whether they understand what that goal is. Meaning is, why is this goal important? Why do we need to know this? What will it help the child to do? So you want to make a statement about how this lesson or how this intervention session is going to help the child perform that linguistic task or the target task better. How is that goal related to general learning? So you express the meaning of that goal to the child in a way that they would understand. And then the next thing that is involved in mediated learning is transcendence. And here you try to help the child make connections between what it is they're doing with you in that short-term intervention and other things that they're working on, say, in school or other communication needs. So how does the goal and the meaning relate to other activities in the child's classroom, in their home, in their community, in their everyday interactions? So how are they going to use this beyond that session? And then finally, we work on competence in mediated learning. And so this includes statements that's going to help the child to complete the task more independently. So we know that often kids can do something in the session with you, but later they might not be able to do that on their own. So here we want to help children think about strategies that they might use in the classroom or at home when certain things come up. So it could be a plan to remember the steps, or a plan to use an organizer or a graphic, or other strategies that is going to help them to employ those skills. So in the next 5 minutes, let's review some examples. So these are examples of mediated learning experience. We're going to review the components of mediated learning experience as applied to narrative intervention. And narrative goals might include story structure events, so things like the initiating event, the attempt, and the resolution. It could include complexity of language, so vocabulary, grammar, dialogue. These are the kinds of goals that we might include in a short-term mediated learning experience focused on narrative. So we might say something like, today we're going to work on telling school stories that are organized in a certain way. School stories have a problem, an attempt to solve the problem, and a resolution. So this is an example of intentionality. So here I used a statement of the goal of telling organized stories, and I use school stories here to acknowledge that there's different ways of telling stories, different ways of organizing stories that vary based on culture, on language and experience. But here we're looking at a specific kind of story and a specific kind of story structure, and we're looking to see if the child can shift and learn that kind of story structure. Another statement that might be in the intervention might include, learning to tell stories helps you learn one way to organize stories that help everyone know what happened in a certain order. And this can help you learn to make predictions. So this is an example of meaning. This is why telling stories in a specifically organized way is important in a school setting. Another statement that we might include during the intervention is, we tell stories all the time. There are stories that tell us about things that happened. Sometimes we tell people about what happened at school or on the weekend. Stories help us communicate with our friends. And this is an example of transcendence. So here the examiner is relating the act of storytelling to other experiences the child might have. So how do they use stories in their everyday lives to express themselves, to express events, to explain things, during circle time, during reading time? We're using stories across these different contexts in different ways. And then finally, how are you going to remember to include a problem, an attempt, and a resolution? So this might come at the end of a short lesson on storytelling. How are you going to remember to include all these elements in your story? So you can use a triangle to remember all the parts and draw it out, or you can use your hand to count up all the parts. So these are examples of helping the child plan or using competence. It has a plan to remember the parts of the story. It includes a visual reminder that they can use outside of the intervention session. So the next 5 minutes, we're going to give you a little bit of time to practice implementing the ideas of mediated learning experience. So here's what you want to do is spend a few minutes to create a plan applying the concept. So think about an area of assessment that you can build a dynamic assessment around. It can focus on any aspect of language, including descriptions, categories, sentences. So those are some examples. How can you use mediated learning to teach about one of these kinds of targets? Now, spend 5 minutes of work at work putting your plan into action. Try it out. Make notes about intentionality, meaning, transcendence, and competence. How would you script this out? So if you don't have a child you're working with right now on this kind of thing, try scripting out what you might say in a lesson to introduce and explain the goal. What are the ways that you can make it meaningful based on the child's age and based on the child's level of comprehension? What are everyday situations that the child might encounter where they can learn this skill, or where they can use this skill? And then how are you going to help them to develop a plan that they can use independently to still be successful using that skill? Now, spend a few minutes reflecting on how your plan went. So thinking about mediated learning helps us get at the big picture of communication. Intervention goals should incorporate multiple strategies that help the child become an effective communicator across different contexts. So think about what happened, what worked well, and what are your ideas for improvement.